from the body. Bring the right foot forward. Inhale, open your chest and stretch your neck back. Exhale and slowly bend forward from the hips. Bring your forehead to your chin if you can. Stretch your arms toward the floor. Breathe softly and evenly as you hold the pose. Now, exhale completely and inhale slowly and come up with a straight back. Bring your right foot back. Put your left foot forward. Inhale, stretch your arms up and neck back. Exhale and bend forward, keeping your back straight. Pull down as far as you can without straining. Relax your shoulders, let them stretch downward. If you lock your right knee, the thigh muscle will become stronger. Exhale completely, then inhale and slowly come up. Bring your feet together and release your hands. Now, separate your feet. Point them straight or slightly at an angle. Inhale and raise your arms to shoulder level. Exhale and twist to your right as far as you can. Bring your left hand to your right shoulder and your right hand to the side of your left hip. Breathe softly as you hold the pose. You may increase the twist as you exhale, but the movement should come from the hips and lower back. And extend your arms. From here, go twist to the left. Wrap your right arm around your chest and your left arm around your lower back. Be aware that along with the waist, the hips are also involved in the twist. In fact, your entire pelvic area should twist along with the rest of your body. This asana is effective in relieving stiffness in the waist, hips, and lower back. Finally, return to the center. Lower your arms, walk your feet together, close your eyes, and relax your entire body. Now, spread your feet shoulder width apart. Bend your knees slightly. Inhale, swing your arms forward and then back and gently make a fist. As you exhale, slowly bend forward from the hips, simultaneously stretching your buttocks backwards. Bring your arms alongside your ears and lower your head. Keep your spine and head in a straight line, parallel to the ground. Do abdominal breathing. Inhale, push to your sides. Close your eyes. Relax your thighs and hips. Relax your back and shoulders. Now, place your right foot on the outside of your left foot. Toes in to the right with the heel up. Rock your hips to the left. Raise your arms to your right side, as though playing an imaginary flute. Have your right palm aiming out, and your left palm facing your chest. Your palms and fingers should be soft. You should also relax your face muscles. To help maintain balance, focus on your hands or some other stationary object. This posture has a very calming effect. You may hold the pose, or if you feel that you can handle a more intense balance, you can slide your right foot up your left shin. But if you're afraid you'll lose your balance, just raise your foot a couple more inches and gradually increase it as you get better at the pose. Breathe slowly and evenly. Outstretched. Interlock your fingers and straighten your arms at shoulder level. Lean forward and move your trunk clockwise in a circle. Imagine you are grinding beans between two stones. Your hips are the pivot point. The movement of your upper body should be maximum. In other words, while keeping your legs stationary and without dropping your arms, stretch in each direction as far as you can without straining. Now, let's go counterclockwise. Try to breathe in time with the movements. Inhaling while leaning back, and exhaling while bending forward. Buttocks should stay on the floor, although your weight shifts from one to the other. sender. Release your hands. Now, bend both knees slightly. Bring your left heel close to your left buttock. Take a hold of your ankle. Flex your right foot and take a hold of the outer edge. Extend your right leg, pointing it upward. Stretch your spine upwards and lean back slightly, lifting your left foot off the floor. You are now balancing on the buttocks. Breathe slowly and evenly. Gently shift your weight forward, left foot touching the ground, bend your right knee.